and we have people that once saw Jesus physically.
Yes.
Let me close this. Look. Can you imagine? If there were people present during that time, and Jesus is saying, some of you here will not die until you see me coming, the second coming. Which means those people, if they had believed, they are supposed to be present somewhere, secretly. We could be having such people.
Chirevo cha Jesu chinotaura kuti kana dai paino akatenda nguva iyoyo anofanira kunga ari mupenyu pakati pedu apa. Asata atevera.
If you are to stand somewhere in the way, you will see it passing and there is no politician in there. He will come later.
Ukamira munzira unoiona ichipfuura isina ina muchairi chete.
People are not clever. Uchiko chinonetsa vanhu ana kungwara chiko na even we.
I don't know what it is, but people are not clever.
Why are you avoiding this skorokoro?
Say usiri kuda kupinda
skorokoro. Because you know it is too cheap.
Nekuti unoziva kuti ine mutengo wakaderera.
And you know the reasons why it is cheap.
Uye zvechiziva
zvekonzero yakachipa. Because of things that are not found in there.
Nekuti pane zvinhu zvizhinji zvisingawanikwe mairi.
So he comes and then he says, ah, muri vanhu vedu. Toda kuti muzvizive kuti tiriko. Tine urongwa watinawo.
He comes just to give you an assurance. We are Let's put our heads together and write down our grievances. How about your own grievance, Mr. Politician, about the type of vehicle you are driving? They put money in their back pockets. For you to think that he is spending
the
high
vehicle.
But out of your sight, his daily vehicle is parked somewhere so that you can remain poor. They want you to copy a leader that will mislead you.
Just
think of it. Is this a good spirit? Men can be evil. Men can really be
evil.
If you see somebody just looking at ways of duping people,
that person
people,
can do anything to you. Kungofunga kuti ndovharasa evanhu vanhu vafunge kuti handina iya inazvo.
All he thinks is about is how can I dupe these people into thinking that I am poor.
Unanenge achitenga-tenga, tudzimba tiri kutengwa, tuchiiswa mumazita evamwe, mota dzichitengwa, dzichiiswa mumazita evamwe, ina handina.
They buy properties and cars and they put them in other people's names.
So a phone, what causes a phone to be expensive? That's where I'm coming. Some phones,
Zimenari,
there are certain functions that you don't find in some of the phones. If a phone is going to have more options, okay? If the phone is going to have more options inside, every extra option comes with a price. Less options, the cheaper the price. More options, the more expensive the phone is. So what makes the phone expensive? Some of the phones are very expensive because of even the material that they use. Because materials are not the same. Some materials are expensive, some are cheap. And the Bible says it. That in a great house, not every vessel is unto honor. Some are unto dishonor. Some are vessels of clay, vessels of stones, vessels of gold, vessels of silver and brass. So if the material that was used to manufacture the phone is expensive, that also makes the phone expensive. Apart from buying the phone, you're also buying the material.
Okay,
I'm coming somewhere. But do you know that when you buy a $1,000
phone,
you can choose not to use any other option. And you can use it for the next 2 years just to make calls.
Hello, goodbye.
You are just making calls. That's one option. Of the several other options that are in there, do you know that there are phones that even from the day you buy it until you use it for, I don't know, even 5 years, there are still other options that you cannot access. So if there is any option inside of your phone that you don't know how to use, and yet that is the reason why the phone was expensive, there was no reason for you to buy an expensive phone. Because what made the phone to be expensive, it is a facility inside there. But you can't use the facility. And what they do, the Samsung people, after buying their phone, they will not come to your house and say, no, this phone was too expensive, so we want to train you how to use it. And they don't even take you through some notes and say, okay, this is how you open. These are the options. You can buy an expensive phone and then you can just use it to make calls, and they will never bother you and they will never come and retrieve it from you. It's up to you. It is no longer their problem as Samsung people. It is your problem of ignorance. Everything that you need was already put into that cell phone. But it's because you can't open, you cannot access some of those options. It is no longer our problem. That's exactly what God did on the cross. When the cross was offered, there were so many options inside of the cross. But the church has not been able to open up this facility called life. And Jesus is never going to force people. Blessings were offered on the cross. Healing was offered on the cross. Life was offered on the cross. But our problem now is that we cannot open some of those options. If you try to open it like I'm opening now, some other people will try to close it. Shut it down. Do you know, brothers and sisters, do you know that Jesus is never going to come back and die again? Hello? There is nothing. Listen to me. Jesus is never going to come back again and die for anything. He has already died for everything. So what is left now is for you to improve your knowledge and to know how to open some of those features. It's up to us. Why are we dying? It's because we are not able to open up this expensive cross. Just like if you look at banks.
Sit down.
If you look at banks, do you know banks, they offer facilities as well? There is an amount that you can never borrow from the bank. Because it is too little. There is an amount that they will never give to you. They will say it's too little. And no kumbira sekuru wako. They will never give it to you. There is an amount you cannot apply for a $2 loan. Listen to me. They will say,
there
are $2 in a mbuya, in a zuguri, in a chi, and I koko.
They'll say, some of your relatives have got these $2. Go and get from them.
So asking for such a facility, they say you are not serious.
There are things that the heavens are denying you because
you...
There are things that you are asking from God.
Senseless
things.
Ngawe opinda church yakaita seinoi wokumbira mwari uchingoti mwari cheromota yamandipa cheromota muchechi yakaita washai imwe kunokumbirira izvo.
Imagine you are a member of this church and you ask God for any type of car.
Muno dzinokumbirwa nemazita adzo kana dziri dzimba nezvimbo.
This type of church means their house according to location.
Hello. My God. Sit down.
Garaipas.
And also,
Zakari,
there are certain figures that they can never give to you because it is beyond their ability.
Yeah.
Those are local banks now, not the heavenly bank. So they will say, we can't give you a billion because some of them, they have maybe, the maximum they have maybe 60 billion, maybe 70 million or 100 million in their own account. But also if you want to get a facility, maybe you want to get maybe $1 million from the bank. Who doesn't want a million? Everyone wants a million. But why is it that the banks are not ready to give $1 million to everybody? Because that facility, for them to give you $1 million, there is a requirement. They need security. And the security has to be more than the money that you want in terms of value. So if you are going to attach your house, your house has to be valued at about maybe 1,500,000 up to 2 million. And then they are ready to give you $1 million. So what they are saying is that if you want $1 million from us, at least you should have more than that.